Hello, welcome back. Today I'm drinking Longrow 10-year-old 100 proof. However, this whiskey is more than 100 proof. It's 114 proof, 57% alcohol. It's matured in ex-bourbon casks, and going by previous tastes, I would say second or third fill ex-bourbon casks. It's natural coloured and it's non-chill filtered. This is the heavily peated version of Springbank. I picked this up a few months ago for around £70, which is about €70, about $100. However, I've seen it on some websites for around €200 and upwards, so I managed to get it for a very good price. Not cheap, but not too bad. I poured some out a short time ago. It's very pale in colour. And the legs are long. It's got a very nice nose. I get some sweetness, apple, orange. And a bit of peat. It's surprisingly drinkable neat. It's 57% alcohol, but you wouldn't think so. It's easy to drink. I've tried it with water. It's nice, neat, and with water. On the taste, I get some apple, some orange, and malted barley as well. And in the background, I get some light peatiness. Compared to Islay whiskies, it's quite light in peatiness, really. I would say medium. On my second sip, again I get a bit of orange, apple, malted barley, and at the back a slight peatiness which takes the edge off the sweetness. I said earlier, I think this whiskey was matured in second or third fill ex-bourbon casks. I say that because I can taste a barley malty flavour. It's not very, very sweet. It's got a bit of a nutty flavour to it. And the peatiness balances out the sweetness. It's not sickly sweet. It's a very, very well made. I tried the Springbank 15 a few months back, and this is far, far better. The Springbank was a bit too sweet, and it had a bit of a sulphur flavour to it. The Springbank 15 uses ex-sherry casks as well, which this one doesn't. I think this one is much, much better. I loved the standard Longrow. However, this is a step up from that. I'm going to give this a strong 9 out of 10. It's delicious stuff. If you can find it, I highly, highly recommend picking it up. It's very well balanced. It's not too sweet. It's not too peaty. And it's not too strong in alcohol. It's drinkable neat or with water. It has a very rich mouthfeel. It's very thick and oily. And the finish is very, very long. It's great stuff. Okay, that's it. I'll be back soon with another review. Take care. Bye-bye.